Absolutely marvelous.
Nice.
Hey guys, Dagan here from PMTV UK, and today I have the absolute pleasure to be joined by Niko Tsonev. How's it going, sir? Thanks for joining me today.
Thank you, my pleasure, man. I love the place. What an amazing room.
It's a funky little room. It's quirky, yeah. And we'll make it work. And as of right now, we're filling it with some gorgeous tones, some gorgeous vibrations, thanks to your lovely, well,
pedalboard
playing and knowledge of the amazing little Eventide H90, which is why we're here today chatting.
Yeah, the main sort of focus is the H90, and it's a box that many people are aware now of. It's been around for just over a year, I believe. I think many people know the Eventide brand.
Yes.
Back, for me personally, it was the H3000, Passion and Warfare by Steve Vai.
Yeah,
these interesting sounds that no one knew how this is done, and then it turns out it's something like, I believe, something like sort of
exactly
the pitch, the delays, which until then, you know, I was not aware of, but that's been on my radar, the brand, since then, and yeah. I was probably 16, 17.
Anyone who was anyone back in the day had Eventide.
Absolutely, yeah.
Like, you. If you had a name in the charts, even if like producers, like yeah, away from rock guitar music and stuff, Eventide was a brand that was synonymous with great sounding products, but products that kind of broke the mold a little bit kind of made people turn heads and
I, to this day, I recognize some records, not just on guitar, but if you take like the Dave Lee Roth band, they use so many of those Eventide sounds on the voices. It was kind of a signature thing. It's kind of encapsulating sort of that decade in a way.
Yeah.
And so in a way, H90 is a new product, but it kind of captures some of those classic legacy sort of...
Yeah, encapsulating was a great term you used there. So all the stuff they've done in the past, like the black hole, everything, even the H9 stuff, this is kind of just in a more advanced, more modern, easy to get around little package with everything crammed in, isn't it?
Yeah, I have been using the H9, the predecessor, for maybe 8 years, maybe longer. So it's been around for at least 10 years now. And they are still seen on everyone's boards. The H9 is such an amazing thing. And for those who are unfamiliar, the H9 can only do one thing at a time. It covers pretty much all the different sort of algorithms, but only one. And the H90, although it can do technically two, it can do more than that with some algorithms. For me personally, it's a lot more than just two H9s put together.
Yes.
Yeah, the way just the architecture, the way you can use it. So it's a pretty sort of inspirational tool for me.
What I love as well is the fact that it's not, because it can do so much.
The H9
did so much as well, but they haven't overcomplicated the front panel. They haven't made loads of menu, like crazy like buttons and switches everywhere and make it look, it's very simple, very sleek, and it looks very nice on a pedal board as well.
I think a lot of musicians, not just guitar players, they get a bit intimidated by the scrolling thing. You know, that's why so many people still prefer the one trick pony, kind of one stone box, and you know, times 20, you know. There are easy ways of using the H90 and the H9 for those who run those systems, namely the desktop editor, and now there is a sort of a iPad sort of control system that you can literally sort of do it on the screen.
Yeah, as you can see on screen right now, we'll put some screen grabs on screen right now.
Yeah.
So for the guys and gals that do want to delve a bit deeper and change some parameters which aren't well easily accessible on the front, it's really easy on the editors. And they look very nice as well. The editors are laid out.
Yeah.
I have to say, once I got to know the unit myself, I kind of use 50-50. So all of this stuff, I would just go in and sort of tweak parameters from the unit. But when it comes to, say, if you want to copy and paste the favorite presets, it's very easy to do it on the screen. Yeah. So I just grab and sort of move it. So it is all, you know.
But out the box, you don't need that to get great sounds out. You can just sit and scroll. And
I think the experience out of the box for many people is just to go and scroll through the presets.
Well, that's the thing with Eventide. I was just about to say that, yeah. Eventide have a great habit of putting some of the most interesting ones first. So when you do plug in, you go, holy, that's interesting.
Which is probably a sort of a dual-edged sword, because so many people think, am I gonna need that? Is that for me? Mm-hmm. You know, but some of the presets can be a bit overcooked. Mm-hmm. But the unit can do all the classic effects, regardless whether you do a sort of a rockabilly or rock and roll or classic rock or whatever. Mm-hmm. You know, all the classic slapbacks, verbs.
Yeah, you haven't got to go crazy if you don't want to.
Yeah. But in terms of a production tool also, if you're working in the studio and you need inspiration, if you're in a band that you don't have a keyboard player, but you need some of those sounds,
yeah.
The H90 really can sort of add it. You know, it's quite immense.
It's immense is a great way to use, great way to describe it. So how are you running it, Niko, today? How would you run it in your setup right now?
So you can see my pedal board on the screen. It can look quite like, wow, why do you need all of this? But in a way, I just wanted to show how I have been using it recently. Mm-hmm. So I have a volume pedal and I have an expression pedal, which you can see on the screen. Basically, I'm using it to sort of control various parameters, which are per preset.
You can assign it to change whatever you want.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And more than one. So with one expression sweep, it can actually control several things. Mm-hmm. Like, for example, I believe on this, I have a... what was it on this? So I have a tiny bit of verb. And with my expression pedal here, I'm changing both the wetness, the mm-hmm. amount of verb, but also the size of the room. So
yeah.
Hence you hear it. So this is, because I'm changing the sort of the size of the room
yeah.
in real time. And if I start it at all 100, it sounds like a massive sort of a... But if I want to sort of literally... And I can sort of literally have it mm-hmm. at my feet. So this is a volume pedal, this is an expression pedal which controls only the H90. Mm-hmm. And the H90 has a ton of gain algorithms, so your overdrives, distortions, mm-hmm. a new fuzz which was added just a few weeks ago. But just to sort of show that it can be used with another sort of external devices, mm-hmm. I have hooked up two gain stages into the insert loop of the unit. So that may puzzle some of you, but the H90 has four ins and four outs. Mm-hmm. And so if you think in one, out one, that's your from guitar to amp. Mm-hmm. In this case, in three and in four and the subsequent outs, I am using to basically have my external gain stage mm-hmm. sort of overdrive pedals. Mm-hmm. And they can be placed internally between the whatever other effects I have on the preset. I mm-hmm. hope that makes sense. Yeah. So in this case, I have a compressor and a verb. This is what mm-hmm. the H90 is actually doing. And with this switch, I can disengage my external effect. So this is just the H90. Mm-hmm. And with this, I'm engaging my external overdrive, mm-hmm. basically, which is now becomes part of the system.
Yeah, which is really cool, because some people might not know this. If you put time-based effects and whatnot before some distortions, it can get mucky and muddy.
And if you use the sort of the on-screen editor, it's very cool because you can place them before the compressor. Mm-hmm. In between the compressor and the verb, or after.
Yeah.
Or even parallel, if you want to run all in, not in a sort of series, but in parallel, mm-hmm. you can do that. So extremely flexible.
That's part of the fun as well, experimenting.
Yeah, absolutely.
Like, sometimes it isn't great to put delays beforehand, but Frank Zappa managed to make it sound great, and Derek Johnson does it sometimes.
And there is a legit sort of the shoegazing scene, it's part of the sound, So basically, I have, going back to my pedal boards, mm-hmm. The zero is basically just a preamp stage on account of my quite low output pickups. I'm mm-hmm. just giving a tiny bit of boost, so the system thinks I'm using regular output humbuckers.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So it's just a clean stage boost going into the H90, and those two are basically in the insert, as mentioned. Mm-hmm. I'm controlling everything by MIDI, so I'm changing presets with that MIDI controller. Mm-hmm. And last but not least, I'm using a sort of a IR impulse, basically, which is the opus by two notes. And that gives me an emulation of a amp and a cab.
Yeah, so for the sake of this setup right here, we're not using any amplifiers, we're not running through effects loops and stuff. Everything's coming through Niko's board right here.
And it's an important sort of thing to mention, because one thing that H90 doesn't do, or the H9, or all the other Eventide boxes up to this date, they don't have any modeling, any amp or cab modeling. Yeah, so unlike the Kemper, the sort of AxeFX or anything else, this is just a platform for effects, essentially. Yeah.
Historically, though, it is the ultimate platform. It's always been the Swiss Army pedal for.
Yeah.
It's that's the box.
Again, for those who could afford it, because it was so, you know.
Yeah.
Expensive.
That's the thing as well. I've got asked previously working in a music store. Previously, you get like the core and the max version of the H9. This is just one unit. There's not different variations. It is just the one.
Yeah. Unit. That's it. And I think I said briefly mentioned that Eventide just released two new algorithms: the octave fuzz aggregate and sticky tape, which is a sort of a, like a modulation type of effect, but emulates a non-linear wobble. As if you have a sort of slightly broken tape machine.
Yeah.
So you kind of add the hiss and the chewed up tape.
Have you got that to hand? Would you mind showing off?
So sticky tape is that sort of non-linear modulation effect. You can even hear the hiss.
You can hear the hiss of the tape. That's brilliant.
And what's interesting is that it kind of it goes crazy and then sort of calms down.
Yeah.
So it's kind of.
We were saying before as well, some of these, if people are new to the world of Eventide and how these things work, these aren't just novelty sounds. People have been using sounds like this to be creative and, like I say, use them as inspirational tools, creative tools.
Absolutely.
To craft stuff that's never been done before.
I think bands like Portishead's, you know, the whole Bristol scene, you know, Tricky, and going back the 80s kind of big hair metal sort of days, the Dave Lee Roth and Van Halen, obviously that was a big part of Eddie's sound, the sort of the off-pitch on the delay. So in a way, it's been a historic, I would say, sort of mainstay of our sort of sound design and what we have been using.
But when you want it to be crazy, you can make it crazy with.
Absolutely, yeah. And the H90 honestly can sort of, people won't believe it's guitar, you know. Even if you're a guitar player yourself, you wouldn't be able sometimes to recognize, you know, some of the sounds that sort of can deliver. But yeah, so it's a quite a lot in quite a small sort of space. I have to say, going back to the pedal board layout previously, to have something similar in terms of a pedal board that can do what this can do, you would have been double the size.
Oh, absolutely,
you know? And possibly three times the money as well that you spend
very
on.
Very much so, yeah.
And I have to say, although the H90 is not cheap by any means, still, if you want all-in-one or super versatile solution, it's like one of the best, really, to sort of go for.
100%, yeah. Like I was saying at the start, Eventide is one of the names where you know that every single algorithm, every single like effect profile that you hear will be tweaked to the nth degree to make it the best it can physically be.
And also, I mean, you shouldn't rely just on the presets. You should kind of spend a bit of time tweaking, because it's such fun, you know. And especially when you start assigning things to expression pedals and incorporating with other.
It opens up the pedal so much.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, and I think I've personally have grown as a musician, as a producer, as a player, just the way I've got to use those effects, you know. I think what I love about this is being able to go really subtle, so you don't need to go overcooked, you know. For example, just, you know, a bit of slapback, a bit of room, or I have this as sort of a, and I can give it a bit more. And that's kind of ready to be recorded in a way. It's part of a, in my mind, it's already part of a record.
Exactly. Yeah, there hasn't got to be a lot of posts afterwards. Everything you can get just home in on the pedal board thanks to that one single pedal.
And then, as mentioned, some of those sort of patent, sort of pending sounds that Eventide revolutionized is the off pitch stuff. So. As if it's a part of a song, you know.
Those are the sounds, like you were saying before, back in the day, that you'd hear on a record. And as a kid, or even a more established musician, you'd buy so many Boss DD pedals and wondering why you're not getting that sound or this or that.
Totally.
It's all Eventide.
Yeah, well, in a way, it's like you could recognize the sound of a guitar, but it didn't sound like a guitar. Mm-hmm. That was my first sort of impression, really. Perhaps I can show you some of the other things that... So those bigger than life sounds, which are sort of the black hole, the classic big verb, and various other different algorithms, which sort of give you that sort of big ambient sort of approach to space. I have a polyphonic room, which I've assigned a sort of like a freeze button on the H90. So my middle switch is so. So for me, they're like a performance-related sort of, you can call it geekery, but I love it because it's kind of extends not just the hands, you can do stuff.
Of course. Like, if we wanted to talk about the pedal by itself and how you were to use it in a live scenario, would you mind talking about the switches and how to go between you?
Yeah.
So obviously you've got a MIDI now, but how would you?
Yeah. I think the easiest way to sort of wrap your head around this is this and that button, so the perform and the select.
And you're allowed to stamp on them, they're supposed to be foot switches.
You are, unless you're Zach Wilde.
Unless it's in your big boots, of course. If you've got a delicate touch.
So just a light switch, they are completely, as well as these, they would give you immediate sort of control over parameters, and they're sort of infinite sort of rotary encoders. so the way I'm using essentially this is your sort of, you can literally scroll through different presets with your alpha wheel here, which is the select. On the other hand, perform gives you direct control over what you can do with the switches. So I've assigned this in this instance to activate my external gain stages, and this can control various other things, and they can be per preset. So this is on off, and for this I just have a freeze function for the verb. And with this I'm basically kicking in the external sort of overdrives. So if you use the on-screen basically editor, you can make any of the switch to do any of those functions, pretty much, But I have to say, this is sort of the main way of looking at the H90. If I go to perform, you have presets, and this would give you the two algorithms that you have basically on this preset. At the moment, I have the harm modulator and the black hole verb, and by pressing again, you're flipping between A and B. So these are one of the two. And when you go to parameters, you're already ready to edit any of your sort of anything, the size of it, the decay, in this case, if it's a verb, and so on and so on.
Yeah, so in the deep editor, you can edit a lot more than that.
But to be honest, no, you will see all of these if you keep scrolling. You'll see all the different steps. And once you're happy with it, go back to program. If you hold it, you're ready to save. Just press this twice and you're saving any of your changes. So I would say this is enough for anyone to get by with the H90. If you just remember, go to your perform presets, the parameters you like to whatever, change it, program, press twice, and you're ready to save it.
Yeah, save it, good to go.
If you remember that, in a way, it's like you're more than halfway there, and then you can just keep exploring. Yeah. So this is how I view the H90. Everything else is just adding additional layers to the learning curve, and that can take, you know, days, weeks, months, even, you know, especially Eventide keep adding new algorithms. So
they're constantly listening to the people that use their product as well. It's not as if they're a very, what's the best way to describe it? Like, if people want certain algorithms or want things tweaked, they will be very receptive and they will listen to the people that buy their products. Yeah.
Plus, I have to say, they have the tech already, so they just need to wrap it up and put it in the box.
Yeah, definitely. You know, so
why don't do it? Yeah.
Cool, man. So would you mind showing us some more of your favorite sounds and demoing some more of what this little powerful box can do?
Yeah, so we have sort of touched on some of the more classic guitar sort of effects. I have just another example of a clean repeat. So this is a momentary, for sound to be a momentary, it can be on off. But again, going back to Steve Vai in the David Roth days, I can't remember what effects they were using. It was all the big fridges, kind of 19-inch racks.
Yeah, you were saying before that to get this in a pedalboard now would be huge, but in the day.
Him having a delay hold, a little switch, I'm thinking, what was that for? And now, you know, decades later. So it's pretty cool.
Yeah.
That's one thing. Another sort of a classic rotary, which is again, and again, I'm assigning an expression pedal to this. I love the rotary sounds from the Eventide. Yeah. These are sort of the crystal sort of delays. Many companies now have something similar to that, but it's quite a inspirational sound, especially with a volume swell. I think it's more sound design, film score type of territory. 100%, yeah, but really cool. Again, these are the big verb sounds. I have a. I love this alto one.
So what are you using the expression pedal for there?
So I'm opening the envelope, sort of, where it's like the threshold. You know, so...
So it is an auto wah, but you're just doing the threshold. Yeah. That's really interesting,
For those who may not have used something like that, that very much depends on the output of your pickups, you know?
Yeah.
So this is a half where you can literally sort of be in between a regular wah-wah and an auto wah.
Yeah.
So I love that, The duct delay, which I'm a big fan of.
Yeah.
So when you're playing, sort of it stays out of your way, so without messing up. So as soon as you stop, it sort of kind of pops up.
Yeah.
Another fancy thing. Some of the synths, which the H90 has several sort of algorithms.
It's always been a big part of Eventide's tone, hasn't it? How fantastic they are as synths.
And this is kind of a... So I'm assigning basically the oscillator to open up.
So that's very cool.
Fantastic tracking. Honestly, it feels so natural. Yeah, it can sort of pass as a synth flare, you know.
That's always one of the best things I've seen people compliment the H90 on is the tracking.
Yeah.
With the octaves, the poly octaves and everything, the tracking is just, modulation is always just perfect.
So I have been sort of playing with some of the other similar, this is the polysynth, again, one of the new algorithms. Mm-hmm. So the previous one was the monophonic synth, so basically it's tracking one note at a time. As soon as you introduce a second, it starts sort of being confused, but you know, in a nice way. But but the polyphonic synth sort of algorithm is amazing. Really sort of tracks the chord. So I have assigned a little wobble on the expression, and then the synth is running into the black hole verb, so it's kind of classic.
That sounds kick-ass, man. That's brilliant.
It's so fun to play as well, you know? So going further up, let's see what I have. I did mention that I have some external overdrive pedals, but this is one of their, the H90 sort of overdrive stage, and I have several. And
so that's just the drive in the H90.
Yes, yeah. And I personally, what I love doing is combining a bit of this and its inbuilt sort of threshold for noise gate with some external, so basically stacking several gain stages. So that's really cool for that. I have. That's, the whammy, kind of. Fantastic tracking as well, and polyphonic, it sounds really good.
What else? Show me what was the cool fuzzes before, like the fuzzes that you...
That is the, if I go to the presets, that shows me I have the aggravate fuzz, which is the new algorithm. Going into basically a touch of overdrive. So it's the classic thing for people combining a fuzz phase with a tube screamer.
Yes.
And the tube screamer sort of mellowing the harshness, if you like, you know, that's sort of that concept. And I have the massive black hole, which is the classic verb after it. This is
awesome.
Yeah, because the octave fuzz sort of, it gets slightly confused and it's most beautiful. So it's very unpredictable in a very artistic way. And then obviously I can introduce the wetness of the verb on the pedal. But I was telling you before we started shooting that I, by mistake, found out if I run the volume pedal, that kind of great, as if the attack has several stages, how it kicks in. And that's like nearly like a synth, although I've got no synth going.
That's brilliant, that's so cool.
Yeah, so again, for me, it's quite inspiring because I can combine it with other things, and in a way you have something different altogether. But I have spent time basically going through the new algorithms and trying to see what they can do.
Yeah.
And it's quite cool, really.
Right, just jumping in for a second here. Niko is doing a spectacular job of talking about how intense and how powerful the Eventide H90 is. But I want to show you what it sounds like out the box quickly. So this is running straight up into the front of the Blackstar St. James 6L6. Obviously, Niko is running it in conjunction with his drive pedals, as well as adding them in the ins and outs of the H90 itself. You can run it a four cable method, like we're talking about in the video. So you can run the time-based effects and stuff, or in the effects loop with your amplifier, and run it that way. All the other stuff's in the front. But this is just straight up, out the box, running through the presets. So I thought I'd just give you a little demo quickly of the first few presets and some of my favorites. This is clean ambient, and it does exactly what it says in the tin, doesn't it? Can't get that unison bend because of the bloody tremolo, but... so touch sensitive, so bloody touch sensitive. Moving over to what's the next one? Bedroom vibes. So that is, like we talk about, the first one with digital delay and a SP 2016 reverb. Now I've got a vibe and the same reverb. Eventide do some of the best univibes on the market. Stunning. Drive delay, that's obviously... a bit of drive with a delay into a dirty amp. That would obviously give it a bit more sauce. So it is just a subtle drive, but I want a bit more. So again, very easy to use on the front panel here. Let's add a bit more drive. Lovely. Wide and clean. Micro pitch and reverb. What I can probably do. Tune there as well, if you've probably heard. To hold down these two guys right here, the bank buttons, takes you to the tuner, which is a very, very responsive tuner, super responsive tuner. Talk amongst yourselves for a second. There we go, any button to get out of it. Drive delay that was, that's wide and clean again. 12 stringy, that's gotta be. You just got to, haven't you? Like we'll touch on the video as well, a lot of the sounds are, like from the factory, are ramped up a little bit. You can be very subtle with this pedal, but even I like to showcase how far it can go in some cases. Jazzy. What can I do with this? It sounds like... that kind of thing. Frank Zappa would lap up an H90 these days. Absolutely. Auto War, again, one of Niko's personal favorites. Very responsive. Says on the tin. Awaken, so that's a polyphony and a tricera chorus. That'll do just nicely. What a great little box, man. Paradise clean. what's that? That's just a weed whacker distortion. Overdrive even. Whatever the rest of that riff is, try and be quick here just to give you so we can get back to the chat with Niko, but. Isn't it an absolute inspirational tool? Shoegazer? Could be shoegazing or listening to Sun O, that kind of. Heck, let's go, let's rattle through. Because you get 99 presets from the factory, obviously you can alter as much as you want. Balance Error. Right, okay, this has got to be Van Halen's Balance album. I can't put the distortion on because the delay is not going to be in the, it's going to be the front end, it's going to sound crappy, but. So that's 90s Van Halen, right there. Like, Don't Tell Me, Judgment Day, all the good stuff. Let's go through to Ambient Fields. The ambient stuff is just spectacular. Space Waves? Let's play a famous riff with a crazy preset. Besides my minor note at the end there, that sounds lovely. Like, you can't get a bad sound out of this pedal. It's absolutely awesome. Leaves of Clover. I'm not gonna pretend like I know Cliffs of Dover. That's a tone right there if you want it. Bravo! Bravo, Eventide. Old vinyl. Listen to the warbles and the crackling on the end of the trail. Get away, man. This is brilliant. Heart attack, what can that be? A nice trem right there. Rusty Claw. I'll get in. They're inspirational tools. When you get a pedal which is quintessentially the ultimate Swiss Army effects pedal, it's just amazing. Slash distortion. Ah!
the last one on the list. We'll get the start. Gentle arp. Nothing gentle about that, ladies and gentlemen. Gonna find Stone Morello. I'm guessing that's got an expression pedal for the whammy for Like a Stone by big old Tommy M. Right, I think that's power 12. I'm having too much fun. Right, let's get back to me. I was gonna say me and Niko in the studio, but you know what I mean. That's it.
Inspiring is a great way to kind of tie up the H90. You can use it by itself and everything that's got inside it with the algorithms to be creative, inspire, or just get great sounding regular
Absolutely.
Rock or blues tones. Yeah, or you can incorporate it seamlessly into the rest of your rig, and it will work tremendously with every aspect of it.
Yeah,
it's such an interesting little thing.
Just explore the different algorithms, what they do, is the best way to sort of get into it. Obviously, there are a ton of YouTube sort of videos out there.
Yes, of course. And Eventide themselves on their channel have tons of how-tos and ins and outs and the history of the algorithms and whatnot.
They're very good with that. And just speaking of the history, maybe we can touch on the sort of what comes ahead of us. The H90 will be able to incorporate some of the cutting-edge algorithms from the H9000, which is kind of their flagship thing.
Yes.
So in a way, it's like a sort of quite a future-proof platform. So if you invest in the hardware, you know, they keep bringing the new sort of toys.
Yeah, it's one of the fun things about the modern era, just USB, constantly update the firmware and stuff. And
sort of, you can joke about it, it's for free, I've got a new Octave Fuzz. Obviously, you've paid quite a lot of money, but still, it's nice. It's something you can't do with analog pedals. And it's always a perk and a sort of an exciting time when you have a new addition. Yeah, so that's kind of coming. That apparently this is the plan for the next year or two from Eventide to keep expanding on the H90 platform. So that's a cool thing.
Amazing. Well, such an amazing pedal, and thank you so much for your time, Niko. It's been an absolute
pleasure.
Guys, I can't say enough. You need to get yourself to your local PMT store and plug one of these in, because as an inspirational tool, it'll just blow your mind and it's so much fun to play with. So thank you again. Thanks for watching.
Pleasure.
See you next time.
Bye.